Joe Hanley, creator of Centorial, and welcome to a quick synth tutorial on how to create a fat analog style bass. Here's what it sounds like. It's a really simple patch. Doesn't require a ton of programming, but it's a collection of very subtle changes, and some changes that not many people even think about. And it's kind of a sought-after tone. How do we get that fat, warm analog bass, particularly from a soft synth?
This isn't your ordinary synth tutorial. This is Centorial, making programming synths easy with video game-like training, teaching you how to program synth patches by ear. Each lesson starts with a demonstration, then an interactive challenge with over 200 lessons. Once you complete the program, you'll be able to create the sounds you hear using almost any synthesizer. Try the award-winning Centorial today.
Now, this is a soft synth modeled after a analog synth, the Moog. And this is called Monarchs by Native Instruments, but there's tons of synths like this. And really, to get this sound, all you need is a synth that has an analog style filter with a filter drive option, which I'll talk about in a second. All right, first I'm going to initialize this. So we have a plain sound. And I'm going to increase our range up one octave. And I could have just played up higher on the keyboard, but I had to do this because later on we're going to get into key tracking and it's dependent upon this setting. Now, we have a square wave right now, but I want to go with a saw. A square would work as well, but after all the settings are done, you'll see how the saw really gives us that kind of true, warm, classic synth sound. Now, to get our bass sound, we need to take some highs off so that our sound is more focused on the low end. So, let's bring our cutoff down. And now we have a simple, round bass. This is fine. This is good for just like a subtle low end. It's great for layering in with other bass sounds. Let's say you've created a bass sound that's got way more personality. It's brighter, but it's missing bottom end. Sometimes a simple analog style synth with a saw, cutoff turned down, layered in, just gives you that nice bottom end. But we want this sound itself to be a bit more noticeable and a lot fatter. And that's where our filter drive comes in. Now on this synth, they call it load, but it's the same idea. We are increasing the level of sound going into our filter. So listen. You hear this overdrive. A little bit of warm distortion starts coming out of the filter. Analog style filters love to be overdriven. Ah, such a nice sound. This is really the key to getting an analog character out of an analog filter. It's all about this filter drive. And you see this on other synths. Another example would be Silent One. It has a really nice analog style filter, and its filter drive gives you the same distortion, same overdrive. So that's really the key to getting that analog tone. But there's other subtle things we could do to get a fatter sound. One is increasing our amp release by just a little bit. So in this synth, we have attack, decay, sustain, but there's no release option, which, yeah, it's a bit odd, right? Well, there is a release option. It's hidden. And if I enable these switches, our decay knob controls it. So whatever our decay knob is set to also sets our release time. So right now, when I let go of a key, it cuts off very abruptly. If I increase it just a little bit, it just gets rid of that awkward cutoff. If I increase it a lot, you hear the note fade over time. Zero. It's kind of unnatural, but also it makes the sound a bit smaller. With this tiny tail, it just creates a bit more sound, and it actually creates fatter notes. One of those really subtle things you'd never think to do when you're going for kind of a fat sound. It also mimics an actual electric bass a little bit more. You know, when you stop a note, it's not 0 milliseconds. You know, it's the real world, right? The string stops vibrating quickly, but there's a tiny tail. So we get just a bit more of a kind of a human real sound here. Next, again, to get a bit of a sort of a real sound into this, give it some subtle character, we want the note to start a bit brighter and then get darker. We want to add a subtle attack transient. We could do that with our filter envelope. So I'm going to turn up our decay first. Nothing's going to happen yet. But if I increase the contour, I'm going to do it a lot so you can really hear what happens. What happens is our contour sets a higher cutoff point for our sound to start at. And our decay takes it from that brighter point down to our cutoff. If I increase our decay, it'll take longer. But we want pretty quick, so it's just at the beginning of our sound. Let's do it around here. And we don't want it to get so bright at the beginning. Just that tiny little transient at the beginning. Now it's just a little bit more playable. It's not so static. It's not so stiff. It just feels better. Now, remember when I said before it was actually starting as a square? Well, let's try a square. Let's see what it sounds like. It sounds pretty good. It's got a bit of a heavier feel to it, but there's something about how the saw interacts with the cutoff. It just gives us a nicer bottom end. That's why I went with the saw. All right, so here we have a nice fat analog bass. It's got a bit more of a playability to it because of our filter and our amp. Sounds nice. But let's say we want to take it a step further. We want to do some kind of little bass fills with it. We want it to be a bit more noticeable, but we don't want to lose that bottom end. Key tracking. Key tracking, we enable both of these switches, will make higher notes significantly brighter than lower notes. So here's my lower note without key tracking. Gets a little brighter. But this change is pretty subtle. Now let's compare the higher note. Way brighter. So now I still have these low notes. When I jump up there, the note really sticks out. And since I got a little bit of extra brightness on that low end, I'm going to back off on the cutoff. So now I get both my low end for that bottom fat bass and then these nice fat fills up top. And then I'm going to boost the resonance a little bit. And what this does is it kind of does two things. It actually makes the low note a bit boomier, a bit bottom endier, and it makes the higher notes a bit more shaped and pointed. So let's listen to the bottom. I'll crank it so you can really hear. It's subtle, but it almost kind of adds this boom underneath. So that's nice. Now what about the high note? You hear that? It kind of just shapes them a little bit. Makes them a little pointier. We just want a subtle. Why is this happening? Well, our resonance boosts our sound at our cutoff point. So if your cutoff is turned down, you'll get a boost in the lows. If your cutoff is in the middle, you'll get a boost in the mids, etc. But we have key tracking enabled, right? So even though our knob is set to here, the higher we play, the higher our cutoff actually is. So when I play that low note, I'm getting a boost in the low end. When I play the higher note, I'm getting a bit more of a boost in the mid, so it's giving it shape instead of bottom end. Again, a simple change, but really subtle. It's these kind of things that separate, you know, okay patches from great patches, these tiny little finishing touches. And last, if we want to add a little bit of kind of swagger on those top higher notes, let's increase our glide so that the notes bend between each other. It's a little too much. Compare. They just kind of bend between each other. They get a little bit of attitude. Problem is, when I want to go back down, it takes a while. So if I enable legato, when I play notes separately, space between them, no bending. But when I connect them, they bend. So now with my playing, I can choose when the glide kicks in and when it doesn't. So I can... I can connect the upper notes to get that bend and separate the lower notes so I can jump back down to that heavy bass. So there you have it. Nice, fat, analog, playable bass.
This isn't your ordinary synth tutorial. This is Synthorio, making programming synths easy with video game-like training, teaching you how to program synth patches by ear. Each lesson starts with a demonstration, then an interactive challenge with over 200 lessons. Once you complete the program, you'll be able to create the sounds you hear using almost any synthesizer. Try the award-winning Synthorio today.